Well, did you know Kansas City is the perfect spot to spot monarch butterflies? We're right in the middle of their migration route, but if you want to catch them this year, you have to look fast. They're migrating to Mexico as we speak. That's why I stopped by the Kansas City Zoo to learn more about these enchanting insects and, more importantly, how we can help them. Monarchs are interesting because they're actually kind of dying off, right?
They are. What's really threatened is that amazing migration from southern Canada to Mexico. They're still in pretty large numbers, but those numbers are starting to decrease because of habitat loss. Because all along that corridor, we're losing the one plant that really matters to them, and that's milkweed.
And talk to me a little bit about monarchs in general, because we all know they start from as a caterpillar and end up as a butterfly, but it's kind of a cool process, and you really do show it here.
Yeah, it's an amazing life cycle, and we actually raise them here. So we'll go out and we'll collect the caterpillars we find out on the zoo grounds. We'll bring them here onto our own milkweed that we grow, and they eat and they eat and they get nice and big until they're ready to make their chrysalis. They shed their skin, they make that chrysalis, and it looks just like the ones in there. They get the name monarch from that gold rim that you see around the outside of the chrysalis. That's unique to this butterfly. They saw it, they said it looks like a crown, and they named them the monarch butterfly. After about 2 weeks in there, give or take, when they're ready, they emerge into a big, beautiful butterfly.
And here we have them here. Eventually, you guys do release them outside.
That's right. That's right. We're raising them in here just to help them avoid predation, but also to use them in our education programs that we have here on grounds for kids to see them up close and really appreciate them before we let them go.
All right. I want to talk more about this migration. What happens? What are some fun things that people don't really know about it?
Typically, about one generation will make the journey southward as it moves through the United States and down to central Mexico and over winter there. But then as they make their way back north, it's successive generations. They're laying eggs on all the milkweed they can find. A few generations later, they make it to Canada. So the ones coming back south the next year have never been to that site in Mexico before.
How do they know where to go?
You know, this is still something that's being studied by scientists. There's a lot of theories out there, including using the sun as a directional tool and using a little bit of the Earth's magnetic field, similar to how many birds actually migrate. This is our monarch way station. It's our own chance to really give monarchs a chance to survive along that migration path. They need places to stop, refuel, and lay their eggs.
You said this is easy to take care of, so easy for everybody to have in their yard. What's in here?
So we have a whole bunch of native prairie plants, Midwestern plants that are also perennials. They tend to return year after year. You can plant some great native annuals too, but perennials is the best way to make sure you got to do as little work as possible.
That's exactly what I need. So we're talking milkweed, which is so popular. Anything else that these butterflies really like?
Absolutely. Milkweed's what we call the host plant. That's what the caterpillars eat. But the butterflies need to drink nectar as well. So any kinds of great flowering plants that you can do, really anything works. But some of the few that we have in here includes like goldenrod, New England asters, some really pretty flowering plants that help give the garden some awesome color, but also give some great nectar for those adult butterflies.
And you're not just helping butterflies, you're helping other things. I'm seeing a ton of bees in here.
Yeah, that's right. So a way station like this is great for butterflies, but they're just a flagship. You're helping out so many pollinators, which is hugely important for our economy here in the Midwest, for agriculture and for the food on our plates.
Needless to say, I'm obsessed with butterflies right now. A lot of people say you can't pick up a butterfly or it'll die because you'll rub off their wings, you know, that powder that I'm talking about. But actually, if you see one on the ground or stuck in a puddle, I always help them and you can too. David says that's okay. He says butterflies are very strong insects. They do migrate that whole way after all. But he does say you have to be careful, and you always should be careful when working with wildlife. Make sure you do your research so you're careful and cautious. And Alexis, you know how to pick them up just right so you don't pick up one wing and not the other.
Right.
We want you to help them, not hurt them.
Really beautiful stuff. Interesting, Christine.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Pretty.